Hey, I'm Brent, you're watching Steam Culture. Welcome or welcome back if you're one of our most favorite people, the longtime viewer. Thank you very much. You know, there's agritourism, where you can go and like be on a vineyard or an olive tree farm or stuff like that. There's food tourism, where you go and do food tours. There's recreational tourism. You go work on a dude ranch and do stuff like that. But I propose a new category, steam tourism. And I'm gonna give you your first stop. It's the National Institute of Industrial History. It's in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Super cool. It's built in the Bethlehem Steelstacks, which is an old steel, Bethlehem steel mill that they made into a downtown area with a great lawn and restaurants. And it's really, really cool to see. But the National Institute of Industrial History has installed, because they had to move it, and renovated a 155-ton Corliss steam engine into working condition. It's actually operational. You can go have a tour and watch this thing work. This steam engine was in operation in York, Pennsylvania, and actually provided all of the water for the city. It would pump the water 300 feet above the actual level of the pump and then let it gravity feed into the city's distribution system. Pretty monumental feat. Took years for them to put it together. So I wanted to put that on your bucket list. It's on my bucket list. I'm going up to see this place because they have other stuff like steam hammers, which we've documented here on Steam Culture. So go back into our old episodes and check it out. Before you do that, stop by our site and check us out because we got content each and every week. Something new. We got new bowling points. We got new Steam Cultures. We got new content on our website all the time. You need to go have a look-see and then come and see me. Look and see me here next Friday on our next Steam Culture. Thanks for joining us.